What I know is it's always an opportunity. Where is the Oppenheimer Fund's opportunity right now?
So the best opportunities from a valuation perspective are outside of the United States, but I don't think that's unlikely to play out over the remainder of this year.
They're a value trap because of all these tensions?
Because of all these tensions and where capital is flowing and because of sentiment. But what I think investors are underestimating is the fact that the U.S., despite all the stimulus, it came late in the cycle. There's going to be second-order effects from all of these tariffs, which will likely slow domestic demand, slow economic activity. And I think investors will awaken to an environment where outside the United States is not as bad as people think it is. Those big growth stories, those long-term growth stories in the emerging markets.
What about financials, the banks of the emerging markets, the banks of Argentina, the banks of Indonesia, the banks of Poland?
Well, I think investors would be better served focusing on the growthier stories of the emerging markets, the Chinese consumer, the 400 million millennials in China that are consuming, right. They're shopping online, they're downloading apps. Those stories don't change within this trade
war. See how he goes like Colbert? He goes right to growthier and growthiness.
Yeah, I quite
Did you
like
see
growthiness.
That? CFA level 4.
Yeah, Brian, what could actually scupper growthiness? Is it Fed? Is it monetary policy? Is it trade war? I mean, what is the underlying biggest risk that you see out there?
I mean, ultimately, what ends cycles is a policy mistake somewhere in the world. So on the United States, we have to consider it from two fronts. I think the Federal Reserve is committed to gradually raising interest rates. They got a little bit of space with the 10-year yield going up, but at some point they flatten the yield curve. That's unlikely a 2019 story, but the risk persists as you move out into 2020. Trade wars, the biggest issue with trade wars is not necessarily the nominal amount, because that's a small hit to global GDP. The bigger issue for the United States is if the dollar continues to strengthen, that on the margin will slow economic activity. So if you remember, Francine, when the emerging markets outperformed in 16 and 17, it's because of a lot of China stimulus that, you know, growth picked up significantly. That's not going to happen this time. The way the growth differentials will, you'll see the U.S. slow and come down to where the rest of the world is. And that's when we would probably see international markets start to outperform.